Hey everyone, I'm Steven21967 and we are in The Infected. So today, I have an idea for building additional fighting capabilities at my fence. So I have swarm attacks enabled, which means over the next few nights and whatever, we're going to have... What are you doing in my gate? What are you doing? So, I have vambie swarms turned on, which means over the next days, we will start to have evenings when we can't sleep because there are infected attacking our bases. But there's a caveat, at least for me. The way I have my current base structure set up, or my compound, the vambies don't know I'm here because my base and where I typically play, as long as I'm over by the base, make it very difficult for vambies to determine exactly where I am. Oh, I got a feather. He gave me a feather. How nice of him. But I understand that the developer probably knows these things and he's probably scheming and working on different ideas to get around our crazy kind of base layouts, the things that we're doing to prevent vambie attacks, because I kind of like it like this. And I know I can turn off vambie swarms, but I just wanted to turn it on. I think it's something I'm kind of missing. I think we need it. I'll leave it on until I get to the point where it's like, okay, I can't stand vambie swarms anymore, so we're just gonna turn them off again. Anyway, so here's what I'm thinking. So I was watching, I watched a couple of different videos where YouTubers were setting up defenses around their fences. Anyway, they set up different kind of, I think they have like platforms and everything that they're setting up around their fences so that they can get above and shoot down on vambies as opposed to like fighting them at the fence, which I think makes a lot more sense in my opinion. So what I want to do here is I want to send up my own defense, my own defensive platform, kind of a battlement, so that I can go up above the fence line and shoot down at them instead of being down here on the ground trying to poke them through the fence, because trying to hit a vambie through a fence is just, it's annoying. If you've played this game, you know what I'm talking about. It's definitely very annoying. So, let's see, we have those set up. Pretty happy with the way that's right there. So we're going to get up some foundational pieces around the perimeter of the fence. And the plan is we're just going to set these this platform to be right by where the gate is. So I'm not going to build it all along the fence. That might be a little bit too much, considering the fact that when swarm attacks and everything happen, with our gate, with our fence, current gate and fence, the vambies are definitely going to come right here. They're going to come right to the gates. They're not going to spend a lot of time along the periphery of the fences. They're all going to come right here. So we're just going to set up our defense to be right here where it's easy to fight them off. And let's see. I'm going to need stairs to get up there. Alright, I don't think we need necessarily more than that. Okay, that's good. So what do I think? I think, you know, I like the straight stairs. I hate the curly stairs. We're going to do something like, do you want to do something like this over here? Or we could just We're not going to have two ways to get up here. We're going to have one way to get up on our defense. Up on our battlement. All right, grab you. And I got some more of you here. And you got more. I'll take some more from you. Hopefully it looks nice enough. All right, so we'll put some stairs right here. Good. Oh God, this mouse wheel. You're killing me. Let's get some poles up. Take a look at where, okay, that's good. You look good. You're probably good. Maybe, maybe not. Try to get these set up so the poles are on. Preferably closer to the inside as opposed to being the outside. Well, I want to do a couple more. Couple more poles over here. I don't know if this will be enough support for us to be able to put a ceiling on top of it. Usually I put up my pillars after I've already created the foundational support below it. Okay, so I gotta go get a bunch of wood, and I'll bring you guys back. Alright, so we got some more logs. We try to get a bunch of logs together right over here so we don't have to keep going and running back and forth. I just try to keep the videos down to whatever needs to be shown in the building process, you know. Try to cut out all the back and forth. All right, let's go over and finish that. That's what we should have done. Let's go over and get these pillars in place. I just want to see if I can put a ceiling on top of them or if that's not considered enough support for to put a ceiling on top of this. All right, here we go. Moment of truth. See if we can actually put this. Oh, it just works. Nice. Okay. Cool beans. Cool and beans. All right, so you can kind of put that there, and maybe we can do one more. Or maybe it's going to say no because we haven't. Oh, there we go. All right, cool. All right, so you can start to see kind of what we're doing. And what do I got here? Oh, I got a ton of stuff. I also have you guys I don't like. I have so much of this stuff in my base I don't need. I really, truly don't need more of that stuff. Alright, so okay, good. Kinda close. We'll get up there, see how it looks. I thought about building some stairs to go up on these giant rocks right over here, you know, way over there at the other end. But you know, let's see, what does this need? Forward logs. But then that means I'm going to have to kite them over there so I can fight them from on top of the rocks. And I think that might be a little bit too much effort on my part. A little bit too much effort for me to have to do that. All right, we got this. Good. Keep that going. And maybe we'll add some railings or something for it. So anyway, this is kind of cool. Nice. I mean, we don't have to add a step here to get up here. We put the foundation low enough. And again, thanks a whole bunch for you guys. I think I don't want to miss out anybody else who came up with these great ideas. Actually, some of you guys keep harping on me about the fact that, you know, I'm not using the X feature to raise and lower foundational pieces. And you're spot on. You're absolutely right about my not doing stuff like that to make my game easier. You're absolutely right. That's just me is just being, I don't know, just being stubborn. Yeah, I think with putting that up there, we're definitely going to want to have something up here to make it look nicer. It's 710. Let me take a look at. So you put that there. So I definitely, okay, I don't want small. So I definitely like the whole railings here. The problem is it's going to be impossible. So we can put them there for decoration, but we got to have this open because otherwise I can't hit anything down there. With the railings here, we will absolutely not have a line of sight to hitting anything down below us. And that's not good. Oh, talking about hitting things, here comes our first customer. May I take your order, miss? Oh? Oh, don't hit that. Oh, don't hit that. Oh, don't hit that. Don't do that. Oh, oh. Didn't get her quite in the head. Okay, took a little damage. Took a little damage. Okay. There we go. So, I know that as I get more and more vambie swarms, we're going to end up with more and more. We're going to end up with having to fight a lot more vambies. So, my thoughts is on swarm, on vambie swarm nights, to just stay in my base and listen for any signs of trouble like vambies breaking through. And you might be like, that's like the worst thing. That's the worst time to do something about a thing is when it's they've broken through your base. It's like, don't do that. All right, what are you being like that for? You shouldn't give me a problem there. All right, it's being a problem. We'll just figure that out in a moment. So I kind of like having these pillars there. I know I probably don't need to have them, but I kind of like them. I mean, I could take them down. But it gives more the feeling that they're being supported and everything. Oops, I meant to do that. And get some more stuff over here. Let's see if we can fill this in. That might fix whatever issue we're having there. You know, it might be that is too close. It might just be that, and I might not be able to get this up, period. Oh, so much. Okay, that's a bummer. Oh, well, that's life, man. Life is full of bummers, right? Yeah, it's full of bummers, and just deal with it and move on. So, yeah, if you've seen who I have in my channel, people I'm following, YouTubers, like following Gage and Game Edge, because they're always very interesting. They have very interesting approaches to problems and games, and to me, that's something I definitely like, enjoy, and it makes things more interesting if you have a challenge that you have to, a problem you have to solve. It's just maybe if I move around a bit, I can figure out how to get that to show up. But for right now, we're just not getting it. So that's a bummer, but maybe later we can figure it out. I could always tear down the fence and rebuild it. I know. We could totally do that. All right. You're there. And let's see. You're there. And you're there. Alright, so let's get you going. And let's see, how much do I have? Oh, I gotta go over here and grab some more boards. Yeah, as much as I would like to have put those railings all the way around on the other side too, it's not gonna work. it's totally not going to, I won't be able to hit anything that's up against the fence, and that's where they're going to be. They're going to be right up against that fence. All right, good. And you need 3-2, don't you? Oh, perfect. How late is it getting? Oh, it's getting almost to the point where it's time to hit the bed, get some sleep, get my energy back for tomorrow's foibles, tomorrow's adventures, tomorrow's fun. Let's see. Let's grab you there. Yeah, there's lots of cool YouTubers out there who have some interesting stuff that they're doing with their bases and everything. And I think, I can't remember if it's Gage or Game Edge who are building like a separate building for Swarm Knights. Like a place to fight from instead of having them get all the way to his base or his fences or any of that stuff. I don't really watch their videos very much anymore because I'm too busy trying to make mine. But the thumbnails tell their story. And their story is, get on my level. Yeah, and I'm trying. I really am trying to get on your level. Yeah, those guys are in a league of their own, so much props to them. And the wonderful thing about Cage and Game Edge is they really got me interested in indie games, because for a long time I was into World of Warcraft, and then, you know, yeah, you know, the thing is, I can't push this any further in it, because it'll have problems with this. It won't work. It'll have collision problems. The only way to fix it is put the gate on the outside, you know? Like, this is as close as I can get the gate to the fence before it's like a collision problem and it can't work. So, well, it's too bad we can't move this out just a little bit. Just a little bit. All right, let's put you... I don't know where to put you, right there. Yeah. So, now that I've got this one done, move bird. Okay, where did I put that? Right, about there. Yeah, now we're going to have to put some more up top. You know, we're probably going to need to put some lanterns on this, aren't we? Some oil lanterns. All right, it's getting a little bit late. That's a little bit of a dark shot. I'll have to get my thumbnail tomorrow when it's a little lighter. I tried very hard not to do stuff like this at night. You know what? Let's just go. Let's get some sleep. Take us about 10 seconds to sleep. We'll get up in the morning and we'll take a look at it when the sun's up and everything. So there's probably a few more things that I can do with it. I probably should finish getting getting the railings done. And I don't know what else. I know what it needs. You guys know what it needs. It needs something to cover it, because otherwise it's... What happens when it's raining, man? Then it's going to be cold, and we're going to be cold and wet. And we got to put something above it. We absolutely got to put something above it. Alright, that's looking good. Yeah, we do need to put something above it, I think. Oh, we have another customer. Hold still. Yeah, imagine 10 to 15 of those going at my gates. Yeah, don't look forward to that. I can see why somebody might want to set up some kind of a fighting arena, if you want to call that. An arena. It's outside of their base, outside of their fences, where they can fight at. Okay, so Let's get this out of my hands. I don't want that in the thumbnail. Alright, looking good. Looking fine. Alright, so we need... I mean, the cool thing is if I want to extend it to, you know, keep going that direction, we can certainly do that. I think that little bump over there will cause us some collision issues. We probably aren't going to be able to build all the way over there. But yeah, this looks nice. Yeah, could use some lamps, lanterns. And, you know, we gotta finish some of this stuff. Okay, so I gotta go gather some more wood, and we'll come back and we'll try to bottle the proverbial imp. Okay, we're back. And you know what? We have a bird in our house. How did he get in this house? So anyway, I think I'm going to stop this video at this point. I think it's going to turn into be bigger than just one video for making our new battlement at our fence. So we're going to do a two-parter. So if you enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the notification bell to get alerts when I come out with new videos. And as always, comment. You guys have great ideas. You're great at catching mistakes that I make. And, you know, don't forget to remind me to turn on the stupid mineral extractor. And, yeah, that'll be it for this video, you guys. We'll see you later, dudes.